possible sources of stresses. These are axial forces and bending moments. You can say axial forces and bending moment. And for these, the stresses coming from axial forces, we call it as axial stresses. And there are again up two types. Axial stresses are up two types. What are those two types? Of course, all the normal stresses are of two types. Even bending also, we will see of two types. Which one? Compressive and tensile. Compressive and tensile. But you have to remember in the and it's a distributions also you have to remember. So if you recall, if this is a body, if force is applied P and P by A, P by A will be the stress generated, and it will be uniform throughout the body. Manje kasa curve yanar, the curve will be rectangular, like UDL, uniform. Whereas in case of bending stress, you will see that it is varying from tensile to compressive. It will vary from tensile to compressive. It will vary or compressive to tensile. So bending moment. And in case of shear stresses, what are the sources? Force along the surface, one. Second one is shear force in beam. Shear force in beam. And third one, who will tell me? For him, I will clap. Third source. We have studied in unit 3, unit 4. Third source of shear stress, tau, sigma. Mansi ji, aapka net chalo ho gaya achha se. Bataiye, kaun sa hai third source of? सूरज
टॉर्शन
कुठला
टॉर्शन
टॉर्शन वेरी गुड टॉर्शन थर्ड वन इज टॉर्शन टॉर्शन सो नाव देअर मे बी डिफरंट कॉम्बिनेशन सो ह्याच्यापेक्षा बाहेरचं काहीच नसतं स्ट्रेसची कारण So, but there will be combination. So, there could be axial plus surface, surface plus bending, bending plus torsion, torsion plus shear, shear plus axial. So, these various combinations. And under such combination of forces, how do you find whether structure will fail or not? That is my next question. Though it's not part of the syllabus, but if we understand the bigger goal, why are we studying? It creates interest. Why? What happens? एक प्रकारचा स्ट्रेस आल्यानंतर if we have one type of force, let's say axial force, it is going to create normal stress. If normal stress is less than the strength of material, material is safe. But if axial and shear force comes together, how do you check whether structure will fail or be safe? नुसते हत्यार शिकून उपयोग नाही ते वापरता आले पाहिजेत यू शुड यूज दोज वेपन्स वेन एव्हर दे आर रिक्वायर्ड ओनली अंडरस्टँडिंग इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट रिकॉलिंग ऍट पर्टिक्युलर मोमेंट इज इम्पॉर्टंट कसं करायचं अनम्यूट करा आणि बोला We have studied in unit number 4. I am giving hint. What are we doing? Normal stress and first of all, we will calculate from that force what kind of stress will be generated, whether normal or shear. We will calculate that. So whatever the sources are there generating normal stresses, we'll add all the normal stresses. If whatever the forces generating shear, we will add those shear stresses. And based on those normal stresses and shear stresses, we will convert into what kind of stresses? Hello?
Principal.
Very good. So we will convert into principal stresses. And once we convert into principal stresses, what is next step? What do we do? We will apply what theories? Theories of elastic failures. we will apply what theories? Theories of elastic failures. Clear? So we'll go ahead. So now we will study the main point that is called as a pure bending. So this flexure formula or beam simple bending theory is derived based on what assumption? That assumption is called as pure bending. So write down what is meant by pure bending. The condition where only bending movement is applied and shear force is zero, such a bending is called pure bending. Such a bending is called as a pure bending. Paishankaika, is there any doubt? Can you repeat, recite? If you are shy to unmute and talk, at least you shout it loudly. Let your parents complain me. Amcha porga lecture lale oradtay sir, kay tar kara. So the condition where only bending moment is applied and shear force is zero, such a bending is called as a pure bending. So how do you get that? It's a very simple. We have seen in the SFD BMD chapter, right? So I had also given hint when we were studying. Suppose if we have this one, this case, this is the simple one. Okay. Let's say A and this is L. Okay. Okay. So let's say this is a same load W. Same load W. So you will have reactions also WW. So what is the shear force diagram? So let me draw the shear force diagram. How does this shear force diagram looks like? So I will go how the rise of W. Then fall. So fall of W. Okay. Then continue constant. Okay. Then it will go here. Okay. So this is as downward. So minus W. It will continue here. Minus W plus W. It will become zero. So this is negative. Okay. And it will continue up to this. Here there is a positive W, upward W. Okay. So there will be rise of W. And then continue up to here, and plus W, minus W, it will become zero. Kai shankai kai ya shear force diagram madeo? If you have doubt, you can ask me. Kunala kai shankai ka? Now shall I draw the BMD diagram? BMD diagram. Okay. What will be bending moment at this point? Can you tell me what will be bending moment at this point? Let me label so that you will understand. A, B, C, D. Bending moment at D is zero, obviously. Bending moment at C will be how much?
Maximum.
No, that is fine. But how, what is value?
W. A.
Minus WA.
So it is pushing downward. So it is minus WA. Let me erase this. So it's not plus WA, it's a minus. Why minus WA? It's a pushing downward direction. So it's a minus WA. Here it is minus W. Connection between this 0 and WA is a inclined straight line. Now let's understand what will be A, B, C, D, E we will take at the center. So what will be the bending moment at center? So this is W and this is W. This will be at the center, means L by 2, and this is A. So we will find out at the center, and then from that we can find out. So how much will be there? W into, or instead of saying at the center, we will say at a x. It will be easy, right? We will take it at x. Some distance x. Okay, we'll take it at some distance x from C. Okay, so how much will be that? It will be W downward, so minus W into bracket L plus A, right? Sorry, X plus A, X plus A, right? And then upward, positive, will be how much? W into Y, sorry, W into X. Samajh laga hai? Bending moment at X we are calculating. And now if you expand it, it will become W minus W into X minus W into A, and then plus W into X. So ultimately what are we getting? Minus W into A. So U1, what it means? For any value of X varying from 0 to L, for any value of X varying from 0 to L, it will have value as a minus W. That means what is meaning of that? It will remain constant. It will remain constant, horizontal straight line. It will have horizontal straight line of WA. And then again, from this side, if you take section, it is pushing downwards. So minus W into A, minus W into A. So this is minus, minus, minus. Any doubt? It's a symmetric diagram. I could not draw it, but it's a symmetric diagram. Kaishanka Eka? Now we are interested in the region of pure bending. We are interested in the region, R-E-G-I-O-N, I'm saying. Region of pure bending. I'm interested in region of pure bending. Which will be in this diagram, pure region of pure bending? Can you mark it by reading the definition? What is the condition? Whether AB will be a pure bending? Very good. Who has marked it? Very nice. So this part will, with the friend who has marked it, so that region is nothing but the pure bending. Why? Can you elaborate? Can you elaborate why you have marked that?
Because bending moment is maximum.
No, read condition. Then your understanding is wrong. The condition where only bending moment is applied and shear force is zero. So instead of marking, I will mark first this region. What is that region? Region. This region is where? What is that in this region? Shear force is zero. Shear force is zero. And that, what on that beam, what is there only? Only bending moment is there. Only bending moment is there. And that's why that this red marked region is nothing but the region of pure bending. So you can mark accordingly. Have you understood concept of pure bending? Kunala kai shanka asel tar vichara, you can ask me any doubt. Otherwise, we can go ahead and start deriving the flexure formula. Any doubt? Okay, chalo, we'll move on. ठीक है, स्नेहल म्हणतात परत एकदा एक्सप्लेन करा. स्नेहल, आपली डेफिनेशन काय प्युअर बेंडिंग ची? ज्या भागामध्ये शिअर फोर्स झिरो आहे हा भाग आहे ना, इथं इथं डब्ल्यू आहे शिअर फोर्स, इथं डब्ल्यू आहे, त्या भागामध्ये जे बेंडिंग मुवमेंट असतं त्या बेंडिंग मुवमेंटला म्हणतात प्युअर बेंडिंग. त्या बेंडिंग मोमेंटला म्हणतात प्युअर बेंडिंग. म्हणून हा भाग जो आहे तो जिथं शिअर फोर्स नाही, ऍक्च्युअली तशी कंडिशन नसते ऍक्च्युअल बीम मध्ये, पण जी बीम बेंडिंगची थिअरी डिझाईन केलेली आहे ती प्युअर बेंडिंग साठी केलेली आहे. ठीक आहे. ओके, सो वी विल डिराइव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज थिअरी ऑफ सिंपल बेंडिंग. राईट डाऊन THEORY theory of simple bending. Theory of simple bending. Okay. So what we will do is we'll have some drawings. Maybe line number one. You can draw simultaneously if you want. Okay, so this is the beam part. I will now start making some sense. I am taking a small section of dx. Okay, we'll take small section dx. Okay, of this beam, and then this is upper fiber AC and lower fiber is BD. Okay, and then this EF is at the neutral axis. EF is at the neutral axis. Why do we call neutral axis? Where stress is zero. So it varies from, if it is at this side, there is a compressive, this side it will be tensile. So in this case, now we can say sigma C because it's a compressive, and sigma T. So this is when compression comes at the top, when the beam is under, so beam is simply supported beam. When there is a cantilever beam, it will be reverse manner. At the top, there will be tensile, at the bottom there will be compressive. Okay, so this is also called as a neutral axis. Neutral axis. Okay, and then this is another fiber we are taking, GH, one of the fiber at distance y, at distance y from the neutral axis. At distance y, so this part of the beam is called as a before bending. This beam is before bending. Okay, and then we applied bending forces or bending movement, and this beam got bending, and we will call it as a A dash C dash. So whatever AC was there after bending, it will look like A dash C dash, E dash F dash, E dash F dash. Okay, and then there will be G dash H dash, G dash H dash, G dash H dash, and then this will be B dash and D dash. B dash and D dash. This is called as after bending. This is called as after bending. And this is cross section of beam. This is cross section of beam. And this is a stress distribution, bending stress distribution. So if you want time, you take your own time, 1 or 2 minutes if you want. And once you finish drawing the diagram, let me know. Okay, have you finished your diagram? So shall I start deriving the expression? So let's do that then. Okay. So I will keep it here. Maybe I will take new page so that we can come back to this diagram, which we need again and again. So some part of it we can finish here. Okay, so let me start right down. According to beam theory assumption, we will have beam theory assumptions afterwards, but we will say according to beam theory assumptions, beam theory assumptions, simple beam theory assumptions, assumptions. Neutral axis, so that is one of the assumption. What is that? Neutral axis, N-E-U-T-R-A-L, neutral axis. Where is neutral axis? This is the neutral axis. Let me mark by red. This is the neutral axis. Neutral axis remains same. Even after bending. So what is meaning of that? It's a length will not change before and after bending. So what is that meaning? EF, this is a neutral axis, EF. Please understand, this will not come for any of the exam, but just it will be good if we can understand some of the fundamentals. E dash, this is EF before bending, E dash F dash after bending. And what is its size? DX. Its size is DX. Okay. And then DX, this length we can calculate from this. So if this angle is theta, you can say theta. If this angle is theta, angle of curvature. So you can write is equal to DX is equal to R theta. DX is equal to R theta. You might have studied in geometry. What is R? This is R from the neutral axis to the center of the circle. Neutral axis to the center. So this R is called as radius of curvature. So when beam bends, if we take two abscissa and if you connect it to center line, that you will get the kind of radius. So that radius is R theta. Then we'll find out the change in length in this GH fiber. How do you find the change in length in GH fiber? Let's do that. So change in length of GH fiber. So how do you calculate? So it will be obviously G dash H dash minus GH, this is GH, okay? How do you calculate G dash H dash will be like a radius we will have to increase. Up to this center, R is the radius, and this distance we have already defined, this is Y, okay? And then instead of R theta, it will be, R plus Y into theta, and minus GH we have already calculated. GH will be same as that of EF, and that will be nothing but R theta. So here if we expand this bracket, so it will become R theta plus Y theta minus R theta, you will get finally as a Y theta. Finally what you get is a Y theta. Clear, right? So how do you expand here? If you see, if you multiply this inside, it will become R theta plus Y theta, and this is minus R theta. So R theta positive minus R theta negative, it will go away and it will have only Y theta. So if it is done, then we will go to maybe another slide. So once we know change in length of fiber GH, we can find out strain in GH. What is definition of strain? What is definition of strain?
Change in length per original length.
Is equal to strain is equal to, I will write your definition, change in length divided by original length. Can you look it into diagram and can you tell me the what is change in length? We have just calculated y theta, right? And what is the original length of the GH fiber? It is equal to EF. How much is that? R theta, correct. It will be R theta, Y theta divided by R theta. So theta theta get cancelled. What you get is epsilon is equal to Y by R. Epsilon is equal to, you get as a Y by R. Suppose stress in fiber sigma, then epsilon is equal to, if you know stress in fiber is sigma, then from Hooke's law, how can I write epsilon is equal to, then epsilon is equal to what will be there? Stress divided by what? Strain is equal to stress divided by Young's modulus, right? Because according to Hooke's law, sigma is equal to what? E into epsilon. Now, what is mean by that? If we can equate this strain and this strain, you get as a epsilon is equal to sigma by E is equal to Y by R. Sigma by E is equal to Y by R. And from that, you get one part of this flexure formula that you will see that when we will combine together. Sigma by E is equal to Y by R, and from that you get sigma is equal to, you can sometimes write E by R into Y. E by R into Y. Okay. And then, so you can understand, we can conclude something from this. Hence, the stress varies with Y. You can note stress varies with respect to Y. Can you see here the stress distribution diagram? So how does that stress distribution diagram looks like? This. From the neutral axis, for the maximum Y value, you'll have maximum stress value. Have you finished this write-up? Otherwise, take 1 minute or so. जे जे लिहिताय ते समजतंय का बघा, नसेल तर मला विचारा. देन वील गो टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस डिरायव्हेशन. झालं का? Okay. Go ahead. So moment of resistance. So next part is of this derivation is moment of resistance. In this same derivation, there is some concept called as a moment of. Just now we have seen sigma is equal to E by R into Y. Okay, E by R into Y. So if we take a cross section of this beam, something like this, and if we take a small area, we'll call it as a del A, at a distance Y, and then if we draw the stress distribution diagram, something like this. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड याच्या रिलेटेड प्रश्न गेटला पडतात टोटल स्ट्रेस काढण्यासाठीचे. सो दिस विल नॉट बी आस्क्ड इन सोलापूर युनिव्हर्सिटी, बट इट इज यूजफुल फॉर दी दिस कन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंटिग्रेटिंग इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर दी आवर गेट एक्झामिनेशन अँड अदर कॉम्पिटिटिव्ह. सो वन्स वी नो द स्ट्रेस How do you calculate the force or thrust? We will call it as a thrust, T-H-R-U-S-T, thrust. It will generate thrust, axial force, either tensile or compressive. If we imagine this side, there is a compressive stress, this side there is a tensile. So this side, it will create a compressive force. This side, it will create tensile force. And they are equal and opposite. That's why it will remain, the beam will remain stable. So thrust on element area, on element area. जर स्ट्रेस माहिती असेल तर कसा काढतो आपण फोर्स फोर्स इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा इंटू ए म्हणजे स्ट्रेस इंटू एरिया ओके सो इफ थ्रस्ट ऑन द इलेमेंट एरिया इज इक्वल टू व्हाट विल बी देअर स्ट्रेस सिग्मा इंटू क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया इज डेल्टा ए अँड देन स्ट्रेस व्हॅल्यू वी कॅन पुट फ्रॉम दिस जस्ट नाव डिराइव्ड फॉर्म्युला दॅट इज ई बाय आर इंटू वाय इंटू डेल ए into delay. Now we will have to understand some of these terms with respect to movement of resistance. We will write what is meant by movement of resistance. Movement of resistance, movement of resistance offered by these are new theories. Sir kalena jhale mantay तुम्हाला वाटत असेल तर दिस इज यू आर लर्निंग समथिंग टोटली न्यू सम ऑफ द थिंग्स इनिशियली यू हॅव टू रिमेंबर बिकॉज मुवमेंट ऑफ रेझिस्टन्स इज न्यू कन्सेप्ट मुवमेंट ऑफ रेझिस्टन्स ऑफर्ड बाय इलेमेंट एरिया विच वन इज इलेमेंट एरिया दिस स्मॉल हॅचड एरिया राईट हिअर इलेमेंट एरिया इज इक्वल टू व्हॉट इज दॅट मुवमेंट ऑफ थ्रस्ट अबाउट न्यूट्रल ऍक्सिस याचा याच्यातनं जो फोर्स तयार झालेला आहे दिस वन इज अ फोर्स अँड यू हॅव टू टेक मुवमेंट अबाउट दिस सो व्हॉट विल बी दॅट दिस फोर्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वाय फोर्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वाय सो यू कॅन राईट मुवमेंट ऑफ थ्रस्ट अबाउट न्यूट्रल ऍक्सिस अबाउट न्यूट्रल ऍक्सिस And that we can call it as a del M because it's on small area. When we'll integrate over complete area, it will become M, that is total moment of resistance. Time being, we are taking the care about this small area. So that will be del M multiplied by thrust is this E by R Y del A and perpendicular distance to this thrust. So it will be some kind of a force some kind of force thrust multiplied by this y and that can be written as into y is equal to what you will get e by r into y square into del a y square into del a okay काय ट्यूब पिटती का y square del a काय असतो सेकंड मुवमेंट ऑफ एरिया म्हणजे काय असतं इट्स लाईक अ सेकंड मुवमेंट ऑफ एरिया फर्स्ट इज व्हॉट डेल ए इंटू वाय सेकंड इज डेल ए इंटू वाय इंटू वाय दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ सेकंड मुवमेंट दॅट इज नथिंग बट मुवमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया दॅट इज नथिंग बट दिस इज नथिंग बट मुवमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया अँड दॅट्स वाय वी विल कॅल्क्युलेट द टोटल moment of resistance total moment of resistance is equal to total moment of resistance offered by beam is equal to we'll have to integrate from let's say sigma this one we will call it as a yt to yc yt to yc that is y at tensile side to compressive side so you can say yt YC of del M this one and this will be nothing but you can take E by R as a constant E by R and summation of YT to YC is equal to Y square into del A so what is this term this is nothing but E by R into I what is I moment of inertia have you studied center of gravity and moment of inertia chapter was there no hota ki nahi first year la and don't worry if you have not studied आई विल टीच यू. शिकलोय म्हणलं की सर शिकवणार नाहीत असं वाटत असेल तर काळजी करणार. एनी डाऊट? हॅलो, आहेत का सगळे? काय शंका आहे का? माऊली तळेकर समजतंय का? ऐकायला येतं का? अर्पिता कोंडुबैरी, सचिन राऊत, उमेश पुजारी, गिरीश कुमार कांबळे, योगेश गायकवाड, प्रथमेश बागे, ऋषी अटकळे, प्रियांका. प्रियांका समजते का तुम्हाला? तेजस्वी, सोनाली शिंदे. ठीक आहे, चलो. सो देन वी कॅन राईट फायनली व्हॉट यू गेट इज यम इज इक्वल टू ई बाय आर इन टू आय. नाव वील हॅव टू कंबाईन धिस इक्वेशन अँड धिस इक्वेशन टू फॉर्म द फ्लेक्चरल फॉर्म्युला. वील कंबाईन, आय विल राईट इट हिअर सो दॅट वी कॅन मूव द बोर्ड अप. सो सिग्मा इज इक्वल टू ई बाय आर इन टू वाय. So we'll have to combine these two formula together. So for that, I will write this I below this M. So it will become M by I is equal to E by R. And this also I will write it in another manner. So what will be that? Sigma by Y is equal to E by R. So what is common in these two? That is E by R. So we can write the flexural formula. Hence we can write M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R. This derivation nahi kalala tar kay lakshat thevay lagel? You will have to remember this formula, and this is called as yala kay mantat? This is called as flexure formula with 100% guarantee. One question comes in the exam, either MCQ or explaining the formula. Can you recite behind me? M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R. M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R. So let us understand each one term of this. What is M? M is called as moment of resistance, or it is also called as bending moment. So I will explain further what is difference between bending moment and moment of resistance. Okay, so M is moment of resistance, usually it is called as moment of resistance or bending moment. I will have only one name. What is that? Moment of inertia. Sigma, again there are two names. One is stress, bending stress, and sometimes it will become strength. When M becomes, when M becomes moment of resistance, sigma is called as strength. When M becomes bending moment, sigma is called as bending stress. Samajla ka? Jasa M cha utar hai, tasa sigma cha apan badal. I, Y, E, R, they are same. They are not changing. It's a name. Y, Y is what? Distance of any fiber whose stress we are calculating. So sigma will depend on Y, because Y will go to the other side, this side. Okay, Y will go this side. We'll see in subsequent teaching. So sigma will depend on Y, because it will be directly proportionate with Y. So when Y increases, sigma increases for constant value of M by I. Because when we select the loads and cross section, M and I values will be constant, and what you can change along the y axis of the cross section of the beam, it will change the y distance from the neutral axis. And at neutral axis, what will be sigma? Zero, because y value is zero. Okay, and then you can say some one side it will be positive and other side it will be negative. We'll see subsequently. And this E by R, it comes related to deformation, when we will see in the second semester. I don't know when it will start, but fortunately or unfortunately, I will be the teacher now, because earlier I was not teaching structural analysis, because that time I used to be busy with structural mechanics 3, but now that's not a part of our syllabus, so I will be free. And you are lucky or unlucky, I don't know, but we'll be together for at least 1 year. Okay, so that time this E by R part will come. For as far as this chapter is concerned, so at least you should remember this part of flexure. So sigma is stress in the beam or strength of the beam. Y is location of the fiber of which we are finding the stress. E is of course Young's modulus, and R, agodar sangitle hoto kunala atavte ka bagu, what is R? What is R? Hello? R काय आहे गौरी? R काय आहे अंजुम, पूनम, स्नेहल? R काय लिहिलं नाही का आपण? लिहिलं होतं ना गदा? What is R? R is radius of curvature. So if you see this diagram, I don't know whether it is there. Yes, somewhere. No, here, first one. Yeah. So if you see this diagram, in this case, this is R. I'll show you this R. So can you guess by looking at the beam, when there is a no deformation, what will be the radius of curvature? So in this case, what will be the radius of curvature? How much will be radius of curvature for straight beam when there is a no before bending? Kiti asel radius of curvature? This arc is perpendicular to the neutral axis. So what will be the radius of curvature? Someone has answered. Let me check. Zero? No. Zero cannot be there. When will be zero? When beam bends completely. Asa jo beam hai na, ikda diste ka maza video diste tumhala, Nikita? 90 degree नहीं आपला radius value असते meter up. Radius म्हणजे 90 degree नसते. Radius of curvature हा 90 degree असणार आहे arc त्याचा, है ना? म्हटल्यावरती कितीला जाईल? अंजुमनी काय सांगितलं? Zero. हा अँगल आहे आपल्याला रेडियस मीटर मध्ये पाहिजे. किती असेल ते? दोन आर्क जुळतील का कुठं? वेदर दोज आर्क आर गोइंग टू टच इच अदर वेन दे आर परपेंडिक्युलर टू द फ्लॅट सर्फेस, राईट? सो यू कॅन सी दिस आर्क वी आर, हाऊ आर वी गेटिंग इज वी आर गेटिंग लाईक अ परपेंडिक्युलर, राईट? सो अँड देन दे आर touching at one point. When they cross each other, that is the center of the that circle. Okay, whereas in this case what is happening, they are perfectly, when they are, when something is perpendicular to same line, are these two line going to meet together anytime? Ya doni line kadhi tar judtil ka? रेल्वे सारख्या पॅरल राहतील, आणि त्यामुळे रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर किती असेल आता सांगा इतके हिंट नंतर. किती असणार रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर? इन्फिनिटी. किती असणार? इन्फिनिटी. सो इन्फिनिटी, अँड दॅट्स व्हॉट यू कॅन चेक हिअर. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट एम बाय आय इज इक्वल टू ई बाय आर, so you can put when radius of curvature becomes zero, we have understood physically, so this part will become zero, and that indicates on that beam no movement is अप्लाइड म्हणजे तो बीम बेंड होत नाहीये. मोमेंट अप्लाय नसेल तर रेडियस किती झाला, झिरो झाला. किंवा उलट चालू करू शकता, एम बाय आय इज इक्वल टू ई बाय आर, तुम्हाला रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर काढायचा आहे. आणि मग काय येणार, आर इज इक्वल टू व्हॉट इट विल बी, ई बाय एम इन टू व्हॉट इज दिस आय. ओके, अँड देन इफ बेंडिंग मुवमेंट इज नॉट अप्लाइड, बीम कधी बेंड होणार नाही, वेन बेंडिंग मुवमेंट इज झिरो. सो वेन आय पुट दिस झिरो, एम बिकम्स झिरो. समथिंग बाय झिरो इज, something by zero is infinity, right? Something by zero is infinity. I hope I have made this flexural formula and pure bending clear to you. Kai shanka hai ka? Shall I go to next point? Nahi tar sir khub bore karta hai mannar, repeat repeat test test karta. Write down assumptions in theory of pure bending. Have we studied earlier some assumptions? Shikle ka apan assumptions agodar? Assumptions in theory of pure bending. Okay, assumptions in theory of pure bending. So what is first assumption? First assumption, let us understand first assumption. The beam is subjected to, very simple assumption, the beam is subjected to, the beam is subjected to pure bending, the beam is subjected to pure bending and is therefore free from shear force. Okay, the beam is subjected to pure bending and is therefore free from shear force. Okay, next one. What is next one? That's the material is homogeneous and isotropic. Material is homogeneous and isotropic. Material is homogeneous and isotropic. Now, can you tell me the difference between homogeneity and isotropy? Again, same thing, whatever we have seen in the these are similar to the assumptions of elasticity, right? Do you remember assumptions of elasticity, unit number one? So material is homogeneous and isotropy. What is mean by homogeneity and what is mean by isotropy? Okay, you are not interested to tell me. Homogeneity, when the material properties are same at this all the location, that is called as homogeneous material. And what is meant by isotropy? When the material properties are same in all the direction, that is called as isotropy. Okay, next. That's Young's modulus is same in tension and compression. Y-O-U-N-G-S. Young's modulus is same in tension and compression. Tension and compression. Okay. Young's modulus is same in tension and compression. Next one, what is that? This we have used in the derivation of flexure formula. What was that? Section remains plane before bending will remain plane after bending. Okay, section will remain plane before and after bending. Okay, next one. What is next? Elastic limit is not exceeded. Next assumption is elastic limit is not exceeded. Elastic limit is not exceeded. And then last one is resultant pull or thrust is zero. What is meaning of that? So suppose like at the top there is a compression and there is a tension. The resultant force generated by these two are equal and opposite. So you can say Ft tensile, Fc, they are equal and opposite. Then only it will create the kind of this theory is valid. Please write down if you want 1 or 2 minutes, I can give. Okay, have you finished write up? Then we will understand. One part. Jhala ka lihon. Shall I take next? Okay, we'll take something called as section modulus. We'll understand a small concept and then we'll derive something. Write down section, S-E-C-T-I-O-N, section modulus. Suppose we have a beam cross section like this, okay, and there is a neutral axis NA, and we know this is Y, okay. This is called as Y max, and for any internal problem, sorry, fiber, this will be Y. This will be Y. And you know the stress, bending stress, just now we have derived from the flexural formula. M by I. Hello. So this is Y and this is Y max. So this will be sigma is equal to M Y by I. So from where it is coming, do you remember flexural formula? Every time you should recall M by I is equal to sigma by Y is equal to E by R. Now in this chapter, we don't need last part. What we need is this much. And from that, you get sigma is equal to M into Y divided by I. Okay, this formula is required mostly. So if you remember only this formula is also fine with me. Now this Y, when we take maximum value of Y, so it becomes sigma is equal to M into Y max divided by I. And then we can write sigma is equal to M by Z. Sigma is equal to M by Z. Where Z is section modulus. Z is nothing but I divided by Y max. I divided by Y max is nothing but, it is called as a Z, that is section modulus. Are you clear? What is meant by section modulus? It's a I divided by Y max. And that's why, again, formula of stress, bending stress becomes simple. That is M by Z. What is M by Z? That's Z is section modulus. What is section modulus? I by Y max. When we have to find out internal stress, we cannot use M by Z formula. When we have to find out maximum stress, it's called as a maximum. When we use Z value, then sigma is obviously maximum stress. So sigma is obviously maximum. Why? Because Y becomes Y max. Y becomes Y max. Let's find out this next term that is called as moment of resistance. So it's called as moment of resistance. Write down moment of resistance. So first we'll start with rectangular section. Moment of resistance, moment of resistance. Moment of resistance of rectangular section, of rectangular section. So if we take a rectangular section like this, okay, it will be B and depth will be D. And this will be neutral axis. This will be neutral axis. And then stress distribution will be something like this. Okay. And then you can note here what will be Y max. Can you tell me Y max value in this case? If this is a D, what will be Y max value? किती असेल वाय मॅक्स व्हॅल्यू? What is y max value? It will be half of the d, d by 2 will be d by 2, and then we can find out z value. What will be, what is the formula of z value? I divided by y max, I divided by y max. And in case of this rectangular section, what is I? Do you remember I value? BD cube by 12. BD cube by 12, and y max is 1 by d by 2, and that is nothing but it will become 2 by d. It will become 2 by d. Okay, and that's how it will become BD square by 6. It will become BD square by 6. Okay, so d this gets cancelled, it becomes square, 2 gets cancelled, here becomes 6. So z is equal to bd square by 6. Now we will apply the formula of sigma is equal to m by z, and from that we are interested in moment of resistance. So in that case, you can write m is equal to sigma into z. When we have to find out moment of resistance, it's called as, you have to use this formula. So now when we are having this m as a moment of resistance, we are calling it as a MR. This sigma E will become strength of material. It will be called as strength of material. So if you choose steel, it will have its own strength. If you choose aluminium, it will have its own strength. If you choose maybe wood, it will have different. So accordingly, you will get the moment of resistance. So you will get M is equal to sigma. We don't know which material, but we know z value, that is BD square by 6, and you can write M as a MR. MR is equal to sigma BD square by 6 is the moment of resistance formula for the rectangular section. And if you put the dimensions B and D, and if you know the material property sigma, if you substitute, you get the material of resistance, sorry, moment of resistance. What is mean by moment of resistance? The resistance offered by beam for the applied movement. And that's why we can look it into a different angle. So if your beam has to be safe in case of bending, you can see that moment of resistance should be greater than bending moment. Moment of resistance should be greater than bending moment. Correct. Bending moment kashavarun yeta ho? Apan previous chapter madhe bagitle. In previous chapter we have seen bending moment comes from applied forces. Bending moment comes from applied forces. For example, this is the beam. In this, maximum bending moment is, do you remember? Central WSL tar kiti yeto maximum bending moment? It is triangular WL by 4. Okay. So you can see that जर बीम सेफ राहायचा असेल तर युअर मुवमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स, म्हणजे मुवमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन, कॅन यू सी, दिस इज बिकमिंग सिस्टम प्रॉपर्टी, दिस इज बिकमिंग सिस्टम प्रॉपर्टी विच इज डिपेंडंट ऑन मटेरियल प्रॉपर्टी. स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल इज मटेरियल प्रॉपर्टी, मटेरियल प्रॉपर्टी अँड बी अँड डी आर ज्योमेट्रिक प्रॉपर्टी. सो सिस्टम प्रॉपर्टी इज नथिंग बट कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मटेरियल प्रॉपर्टी अँड system property, material property and, sorry, material property and geometric property, material property and geometric property. So here we can see moment of resistance is, just I will elaborate further, I hope you have written this, we'll move on. So what I can say is, suppose I have to design a beam of a certain moment of resistance, it doesn't matter whether that beam is of steel or the beam is of wood. So you can find out that. So why I want MR of wood should be equal to MR of steel. How do you do that then? You can put the formula here. Sigma will become sigma wood, B of wood d of wood square divided by 6, right? Divided by 6. Can you see? Kuni manla tumhala apan beam steel cha jagi wood cha taku shakto ka tevadach load ghenyasathi? Yes, pan kay badaltil? Dimensions badalu shaktil. What will change? Dimensions. So for example, I am putting here, so and then you have sigma steel is equal to b steel d steel square divided by 6, and then 6 gets cancelled. And suppose, let's say sigma w is around 8 and sigma steel strength of steel is around 120, so you can substitute these values here and you will see the, and then we will say width is same. Okay, width is same. Wood chi width ani steel chi width pan same hai. Tar kashat farak yel fakta depth badaltil. Kiti times depth yeti apan kadu shakto de. So you can see BW is 8 and DW square divided by, already we have removed that, and this side it will be 120, and then BS is BW only. So and DS square. So this gets cancelled. So DW square is equal to 120 divided by 8 into DS square. Okay. Can you do the calculation and tell me how much that ratio comes? 120 by 8 and then square root of 8. Is equal to 15, and then square root of 15, how much it comes? Square root of 3.87. So you can see the DW will come as a 3.87 DS. Manje zar, imagine zar wood steel sa beam ahe maja gharamade. Techa zagi mala wood sa beam takai chai. Same width thevli mi. Tar techi depth kiti hoil samja tya steel cha beam chi 100 mm depth asel. Tar mala wood cha beam chi depth vaadel. Pan tevdach load ghayla to sashakta asel. It will take same amount of load. So only depth, what amount of depth will be required? This will be the depth required of steel. Then it will become wood chi depth ka asnar hai, 3.87 of steel. So that is 387 mm will be required. Samajhte ka saglyanna? Kuni ahe ka tithe? No answer I'm getting from them. Nikita, samajhte ka tumhala? Akanksha Kale, Gauri, Anjum. Why are you not responding? Unam, Tejasri, samajhte ka tumhala? What point I am trying to make? Baryazda confusion hota ki are steel cha jagi apan wood taku shakto ka? Tar taku shakto. Tyamule baghu shakta tumhi kadhi ghar dhabyachi ghar astat, kadhi steel che girder astat, kadhi RCC che astat. So it doesn't matter what material we are taking, as long as we are maintaining the MR greater than bending moment coming on that structure. The beam or the another bending moment peksha moment of resistance apla nehmi ka asla paije jaast asla paije. Kami zala ki kay hoil, our beam will fail. If moment of resistance is less than bending moment, then our beam will fail. Okay, so let's try this for the hollow rectangular section. Okay, let's try this part. Write down moment of resistance for hollow rectangular section. Okay, hollow rectangular section. So how do you see the hollow rectangular section? Something like this. Okay. And then something like this. Okay. And then you have, let's call as outer width as a capital B. Okay. Outer depth as a capital D. Then inner width as a small b, inner depth as a small d. Okay, same procedure again. We have to mark neutral axis, yani. Now in this case, what will be neutral axis? That is y max. This will be y max. How much will be y max? Who will tell me? Ata tar sanga, kiti asel y max?
2 cube by 12.
Y max paije aplyala, kiti paije? D by 2. Y max is capital D by 2. Please don't subtract and then divide by 2. That is sometimes student try to do capital D minus small d by 2. No, it's a distance of extreme fiber. What is the definition of y max or y? Distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis. That's a d by 2. And then what is z definition? What is z definition? I by y max. I by y max is equal to I. For this case, you have to take moment of inertia of bigger section and you have to subtract the moment of inertia of hollow section. So it will become BD cube by 12 minus BD cube by 12. And of course, Y max is 1 by D by 2. That will become 2 by D. 2 by D. And then you can see the denominator is common. So it will become BD cube minus BD cube divided by 12 into 2 by D. And you can say 2 ones are 2, 2 six are 12. So you'll have BD cube by 12, sorry, BD cube minus BD cube divided by capital D. And once you know Z, you can substitute into our formula. Now we have found MR is equal to sigma into z. So it will become sigma into BD cube minus BD cube by D. Any doubt, write down in one or two. Now you can start putting your attendance by writing name and attendance. In chat box, write down your name and attendance. काय शंका आहे का? नसेल तर वन मोर सेक्शन विल टेक और मे बी टू मोर सेक्शन इन दिस सेक्शन मॉड्यूलस मोमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स पार्ट वी कॅन फिनिश. स्टार्ट मार्किंग युअर अटेंडन्स. Okay, we'll do it for the circular section and then hollow circular section. We have, I guess, that much time. Another 15 minutes are there. So we'll do that. Moment of resistance movement of resistance for circular section. Circular section. So if you take a circular section, okay, of diameter d, it will have some kind of stress distribution like this, and you can see the y max will be how much in case of circular section. What will be y max? Can you tell me now at least kiti asel y max? Head distance kiti asnar hai? Everyone, is it that difficult? Huh?
D by 2.
It's very D by 2. Y max is D by 2. And what is I for this? Can you tell me for circular section? We have studied, I guess. Y max, Z is equal to I divided by Y max is equal to so it will become BD cube by 12. Okay, I for circular section is BD cube by 12, and Y max is, it will be 2 by D. D by 2 will become D by, I'm sorry, kai chuklo ga? For circular section, chuklo ho sanga na? For circular section,
4 divided by 64.
Very good. So pi d raised to 4 by 64 is the value. So it will, it should become pi d raised to 4 by 64, and then this 2 ones are 2, 232, and d1 d, and d cube. So it will become pi d cube by 32, and then you can write M is equal to sigma into z. So sigma into, so finally it will become sigma into pi d cube by 32. Pi d cube by 32. So it will become sigma pi d cube by 32. Okay. क्लियर है? काय शंका आहे का? खूप सोपा आहे. चला, तुम्ही हॉलो रेक्टॅंग्युलर समजलं होतं, हॉलो सर्क्युलरचं करणार. विल यू डू इट फॉर एम आर फॉर हॉलो सर्क्युलर? मुवमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स फॉर हॉलो सर्क्युलर सेक्शन. मुवमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स फॉर hollow circular. Movement of resistance for hollow circular section. 1 minute. For hollow circular section. Can you do that? Let's see if you can do it. If you have, let me take circle. If you have circle like this, another circle like this, I can move it. Okay, it's a concentric circle. Don't go by my wrong drawing. So diameter of internal circle is D, and diameter of external circle is capital D. Now tell me, what is y max in this case? What is y max in this case? Hello, it will be capital D by 2. And what is z value? It will be I by y max. Okay, and what will be I? Pi d raised to 4 by 64 minus by outer sa moment of inertia minus inner sa moment of inertia. So it will be pi d raised to 4 by d raised to 4 by 64 and into y max, it will be 2 by d. Okay, and then you can see that 64, you can denominator is common. So it will, and then d1s are the d cube, it will become. So pi d, and no, I'm sorry, it will not become d. D raised to 4 minus, you can say pi, you can, pi also you can take common. So it will become d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 divided by 32d. And once you have that z value, you can write MR, moment of resistance, is equal to sigma into z, and then sigma into pi into d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 divided by 32d. Chalo, mark your attendance. Tell me if you have any doubt. And tomorrow we will take problems. So shall we recall what we have studied? We have another 8 to 9 minutes. Okay. So kunala kai shanka asel tar vichara. We'll recall we started with something called as how stresses comes in beam. So this is syllabus. So almost all the theory part we have covered today. Okay. And then we have understood like the sources of stresses which will generate normal stress and shear stress, and one of the source of normal stress is bending stress. And bending stress is like when a beam undergoes a bending, it will have shear force as well as bending moments, and that's why it will create the bending stresses because of bending moment. It will create the bending stresses because of bending moment. Okay. And then we have understood something called as a pure bending. What is pure bending? The condition where only bending moment is applied and shear force is zero. Such a bending is called as pure bending. Such a bending is called as pure bending. And we have seen one of the condition. You can try some other conditions also. There is a, let me show one more condition for this. There is something called as two-point bending. I guess in that also it will have the same condition. Let's say W, this will be W, this will be W, and you call it as A, and let's say L. Okay, and in that case, obviously shear force will be this one, W minus zero, then minus W, and this. So this region becomes zero shear force. Now bending moment. Bending moment is W into A upward, positive bending moment is there. W into A, positive bending moment, and then this will be connected like this. So you can see that at any distance x, you can find out at any distance x what will be that. So it will be W into x plus A minus W into x. It will obviously again give you WA. Okay. So that's how this is called as a two-point bending. When you will go for the PG or when you will come in the campus, you can ask, there is some machine called as two-point bending. Maaz lecture sample. Okay. So is it clear? That's what we have seen. And then next is we saw the theory of simple bending. We saw the theory of simple bending. And in that, what we saw is we derived flexure formula. So in this flexure formula, what we started with based on the assumptions of assumptions of pure bending, and from that we got the finally flexure formula, that is m by I is equal to sigma y is equal to e by r. And then we had assumptions. If we recall, beam is subjected to pure bending, is therefore free from shear force. So obviously pure bending definition itself says that the it's a free from shear force. Material is homogeneous and isotropic. And then the Young's modulus is same in tension and compression. Section remains plane before bending and will remain plane after bending. Elastic limit is not exceeded, and then the resultant pull and thrust is same. And then we saw something called as a section modulus. What is section modulus? Section modulus is I by Y max, that is Young's moment of inertia divided by maximum distance of extreme, or you can say distance of extreme fiber, Y max. And from that we derived the moment of resistance of this rectangular section, then moment of resistance of hollow rectangular, and moment of resistance of circular section and hollow circular section. So those who have marked attendance, they can leave the class. Others, please mark quickly. I'm going to close in 2 minutes. Thank you for your time and patience.